Kumasta, my name is Phillip Trumata Kieffer, and I'm a graphic designer, illustrator, and lover of all things music. Today I want to talk to you guys about something straightforward, and that's giving critique. Not just the constructive, but I want to make you all aware of the destructive ways as well. While I was studying graphic design in college not too long ago, there would be these group critiques every 2 weeks or so, where the class would hang their work up on the wall and critique each other. Our teacher would supervise these sessions loosely and give her 2 cents every now and then, but for the most part, we were throwing things against the wall to see what would stick. It was during this time that I realized that our teacher was helping us develop our own critique techniques and realize the value of a critique that provides forward momentum. Now, giving critique is an important part of being an artist because it offers both parties a new perspective. Critique should be an open conversation. It shouldn't feel like a rejection or an attack. And that's what bad critique is. It's a one-way conversation, a one-way street. It doesn't lead to nowhere, and doesn't leave the artist with any idea of where to go next. Now, to start off on the right foot and inviting good critique, the first step is to always lead with a compliment. I don't care if you have to reach for it, they will tune you out immediately if you open with a naysay. Next, find out what the author's intent is, if you can. Find out where their destination is, their vision. From here you can deduce if it is being communicated and if they're at least pointing in the right direction. Sometimes you won't be able to complete the step because the author isn't there. You could be leaving a comment on a forum or a video. Either way, from here you can begin the constructive criticism based on what is being communicated to you. Focus on streamlining a clear message, removing diluting and distracting elements. This will result in a message that will most likely resonate with the audience. What you're personally responding to can be a factor as well. There's not one cut and dry way of measuring good art, and sometimes your perspective doesn't line up with the intent of the creator. But offering your own perspective will almost always reveal dimensions of the work that an artist might not have considered. Be firm but polite. Lastly, it's good to close out with another compliment for a nice digestible critique sandwich. This might already be taken care of provided you offer your own perspective in as positive a way as you can. Either way, you should try your best to finish strong with good vibes. This last compliment shouldn't be to just end the process. It should hit on the beats of what is working in the piece and encourage the author to enhance that. This gives them forward momentum and makes sure they don't leave the conversation feeling lost. It gets the gears turning and can lead to even stronger ideas for future works. Remember, compliment, constructive criticism, your perspective, and another compliment. I encourage you to try these guidelines out and make them your own. You might surprise yourself with the type of ideas you respond to and the actualization of your own tastes. If you've made it to the end of this video, I want to thank you for your time. Leave a thumbs up if you liked this video, thumbs down if you didn't. Remember, I'm open to critique myself. Let me know what you guys think about critique down in the comments. I'd love to hear what your own experience is, good or bad. That's all for today, friends. I'll see you when I see you.